You all know I'm a big fan of Excel, but there are other programs like Excel out there. One that I get questioned a lot about is Google Sheets. And often I get comments like this one, or this, and this. So I decided I need to dig deeper and find out more about Google Sheets. And for me, the best way to do this was to switch my work from Excel to Sheets for a few months. Now, of course, there were things I had to do in Excel, which I continue to do, but I did switch the majority of my work, and this forced me to really learn all I can about Sheets, to the point where I decided to create a head-to-head contest between the two. In this video, we're going to cover the features where Sheets has an edge over Excel. Keep in mind, this is just an overview of features where I believe Sheets is better. And to be clear, I'm comparing Sheets to the current version of Excel in Microsoft 365. Before we get started, I'd like to thank ExpressVPN, who's a sponsor of this video. I have a special offer for you in the description below. Check it out when you're ready. I'm going to chat more about them towards the end. Now let's get to the superpowers of Google Sheets. Number one, searchable dropdown lists. In Sheets, dropdown data validation lists are automatically searchable. Let's say here, I want to add a dropdown list for position. I have here a list of names and position that currently goes up to line 43. All I have to do here is right mouse click, go to data validation. List from a range, select the range, that's the position. Now I'm also going to add some additional rows to account for future data. And let's click on OK. Let's reject input in case the input isn't from the list and click on save. Now I get my dropdown list added here. And the great thing is it's searchable. When I type assistant, my list is restricted to the positions that include the word assistant. If I type sales, I get the positions that include the word sales. Now, in addition to this, we also get two side benefits. Remember I added some empty rows on the bottom? They're not included in the dropdown list. But the moment I get data there, so let's say I have a new position, that position is automatically included. Another side benefit is that duplicates are automatically removed. Notice in my data set, I have duplicates for accountant and for sales representative, but I get unique values in my dropdown. This makes creating, maintaining, and using dropdown lists a lot easier. Number two, the split function. With the split function, you get to dynamically split your text into multiple columns. All you have to do, type in split, open the bracket, reference the cell that you want to split, and then define the delimiter. So in this case, my delimiter is a space, so quotation, space, quotation, close bracket, press enter, and that's it, your results spill. You don't have to worry about using left or right functions. You can just use the split function. Now, in addition to this, you can also define multiple delimiters. So if you wanted to split these names into separate columns, notice that they are using different delimiters. That's not a problem for split. Our text is right here. Our delimiters can all be put together inside the delimiter argument. So here I have a slash, I have a comma, and down here I'm using a dash. So let's just put them all in, close bracket, press enter, and that works great here. Let's send this down, and our results spill and are split correctly. Number three, automatic refresh in pivot tables. In Google Sheets, your pivot tables automatically refresh the moment your source data changes. So check this out. Here I have a pivot table showing the average salary, employee count, and unique positions based on this data set. Now this part, unique positions, this is also something that Excel doesn't have. We have the ability to do a count unique. Now check this out. I'm going to add more data to this, and this is going to automatically refresh. Now just so that you can see it better, let's hide these rows here and let's add a new record on the bottom. Now keep your eyes on the pivot table. I have a new department legal. It automatically shows up in my pivot table. And check this out. I'm going to press enter, and it's inside the pivot table. I remove it, it's gone from the pivot table. Number four, import XML to import any data from any web page, even if it's not a table. So for example, on this page here, we have the exchange rate table. There are actually two tables. One is up here, another one is down here, and we have a third data set that's on the side. Now, officially, only these two are tables. Excel Power Query will only see these two. It's not going to see this data set on the side because this is not officially a table. With import XML, we can bring it into Google Sheets, because this function enables us to look into the HTML code and grab the node name or the attribute name from the source code. This gives us the ability to pretty much bring any part of a web page into Sheets. So here, to grab this part, all I have to do is type in import XML, put in the URL, and then the node name and the attribute name from the source code. Close bracket, press enter, and I grab that information. Now, in case you're wondering how we can bring the table information, well, for that, we can easily use the import HTML function instead, put in the URL, the query type, the table index, and we have our table imported. If we want the second table, we just have to change this to a 2, and we get the second table imported. Number 5, lookup on images. In Sheets, you get the ability to insert an image in a cell or over cells. If you, for example, have an image over cells that you want to put inside a cell, you just have to click on the options here and put image in selected cell. The moment an image is in a cell, it kind of acts like a value. You can reference it, and you can also use formulas on it. So for example, in this dashboard here, I want to take a look at a department, and then I want to show the picture of the department head. Here I've done a VLOOKUP on the picture names here. So when I switch this from finance to marketing, the picture for the department head updates as well. The great thing is that you can also get the spill effect on pictures. So for this department, we just have one manager. But if I switch to, for example, the finance department, I have two managers, formula spill and so do images. Number 6, search and replace with regex. Regex stands for regular expression. With regular expression, you get the ability to search for a pattern and replace that with something else. So for example here, if we wanted to remove the middle names, all we have to do is highlight our area, press Ctrl H to bring up Find and Replace. Now we are looking for a pattern, we're not looking for a specific text. So I'm just gonna put in that pattern and replace it with this expression. This basically defines what I wanna keep. Then I need to activate the search using regular expressions. Now if you wanna read more about them, you can do that here. But check this out, before I replace this, when I click on Find, it's only finding the names that have middle names. And when I click on Replace All, that middle name is gone. That's how easy it is to use search and replace with regular expressions. Now, in addition to this, you also have functions that use regex. For example, regex replace, extract, and regex match. Number 7, insert QR codes with the image function. The image function allows you to retrieve an image by typing a URL. So for example, if I put in this URL, close bracket, press enter, I get the image returned. And this is kind of like a value. I could reference it like this. In addition to this, I get the ability to use the image function to automatically insert QR codes. You just have to type in the link for the Google API, and then there are some requirements. So you have to add in the size of the QR code that you want. You also have the ability to define the output encoding, so default is UTF-8. You can also specify the error correction, default is low. And then you can just reference the cell where you have the link, and that's it. You get your QR code automatically retrieved. And because this is a function, you can send this down and it automatically applies to the other links. Number 8, translate with a function. you get the ability to create spreadsheets in different languages using Google Translate. Let's say, for example, I want to translate this question into another language. All I have to do, type in Google Translate, select the text I want to translate, the source language, so this question is in English, so I'm going to put EN, and then the target language I want to translate it to. So let's first go with DE, close bracket, press enter, and I get the question in German. If I wanted it in another language, I just have to put the language code in here. So let's say I want it in Japanese, JA, press enter, and I get the question in Japanese. This gives you the ability to create reports that support different languages. So let's say I had created this report and I want to send it to the companies that are in other locations. I can give the users the ability to switch the language to another language. So let's go with French, for example, or Russian, or any language that's supported by Google Translate. Number 9, chat inside your spreadsheet as you collaborate. Sheets makes it really easy to collaborate with your colleagues. So let's say I wanted to invite my colleague to collaborate with me on this sheet. All I have to do is share this with them, put in their email address, notify them by sending them a message if I want, and click on send. When your colleague is in the spreadsheet, you can see it up here, and you get the ability to chat with them. This makes collaboration a lot easier. In addition to chat, you also get to add comments and at mention someone who you're collaborating with. Number 10, query function to supercharge your data analysis. With the query function, you get to create complex reports with a single formula. So for example, here I have information on three different divisions. I have information by region, app, actual sales, and budget sales. Let's say in the first example, I want to get total actual sales by division in the columns and region in the rows. So I need to pivot the division column, and I also need to summarize the sales column. I can do all of this with a single function. All I have to do is type in the query function. This function uses query language, which is very similar to SQL language. This gives us a lot of flexibility. I can select what I want, how I want it summarized, grouped by, and in case I want to pivot information, I just have to put it in here, press enter, and I get everything back, including the headers. Let me show you some other examples. Here I've made the division flexible, so I have the ability to select between different divisions. You can even take this function to another level by creating automatic totals that move with our data set. I mean, this looks a bit crazy, but it's not difficult to do once you get the hang of this function. When I change this from game to productivity, notice my total shifts as well. It's like a pivot table, but all of this is just this formula. Even the difference column is calculated inside this function. Now, in addition to these, there are some functionality that are similar both on the sheet side as well as Excel, but I find they're more flexible on the sheet side. So for example, Google Finance function. This gives us the ability to retrieve current as well as historical stock information. In Excel, we have a new function that's not fully rolled out yet. It's called Stock History. It's similar to this, except Google Finance allows us to retrieve more attributes about the stock. Another function that I find to be more flexible on sheets are sparklines, because sparklines are written by typing a function. This means you can embed other functions inside them. So here I'm directly retrieving Google Finance data inside the sparkline. When I switch my view from Amazon to Tesla, this information updates automatically. So that's my list of the superpowers of Sheets. If you'd like to learn more about any of these features, comment below and let me know. Many thanks to ExpressVPN for sponsoring today's video and supporting my channel. A VPN is basically a private connection between your computer or mobile and a virtual server. This has several advantages. The most important one for me is security. I often work in hotels, coffee shops, or at airports, and most of the time, this means connecting to an unencrypted Wi-Fi network. A hacker connected to the same unencrypted Wi-Fi network can easily steal your personal information. It literally just takes basic computer knowledge to gain access to your passwords, financial details, or even your emails. By using ExpressVPN, I can secure my internet connection with the click of a button using the highest standards of encryption currently available. This not only gives me peace of mind, but also privacy. With ExpressVPN, you can also watch geographically restricted content by connecting to any of their servers in 94 different countries. So this way, you can still watch your favorite show or channel, even when you're traveling abroad. And because ExpressVPN is sponsoring today's video, I have a special offer for you. Find out how you can get 3 months free by clicking the link in the description box below. That's expressvpn.com/XCLplus. So that's it for today. In the next video, we're going to cover Excel superpowers, so stay tuned for that. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't done so already, so that I can see you in the next video.